if we're gonna do Mr. Krabs versus ChillBro, this has gotta happen in the Krusty Krab.
Oh yeah, obviously.
Somebody wants a bunch of crack over
Oh, you boy, I'm selling a slave in here.
Like that. Wanna go pick it up?
I can't wait to have a video where it's just like all of us leave the VC and the only commentary there is for the video is just Green talking to his co-workers.
Hey, sorry.
Alright, now that we have the right sighting...
Is that Hall Inspector Green?
It's just Crash.
In a shopping cart.
Wait, is that not my Egyptian?
Wait, hold on, you guys. I'm trying to listen.
It's like shopping carts. But it's just a cardboard that's just gives a great card towards the front.
Alright, well, that's Health Inspector talking to Green. Cardboard. Hey, El Match, really?
ChillBro versus Mr. Krabs. I might have to do the clickbait with this and just say it's Patrick versus Mr. Krabs. And when you click on it, they just get this bullshit, which is what we always do.
It should be like Patrick Bacon versus Patrick.
I'm gonna need to eventually start doing the most insane clickbait titles, expecting an actual video, and then they get the most ghetto type of like production once they actually click on it.
Right.
Get them smosh.
The goat thing.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry, guys. General manager was talking to me.
Yeah, I know. I said, is that health inspector?
Yeah.
He's talking about like trash in a shopping cart and cardboard.
Yeah. So now my headphones decide to pick all that up. But when I'm like trying to talk to you guys, in the back, it just doesn't hear anything.
Yeah, you can't hear you.
Random as fuck, dude. I don't know. I mean, you can always go back on the videos and hear yourself, but I don't think you'll do that.
Nah. Maybe I'll do that in like 30 years, but Jim will probably delete the channel by then.
I think the channel's more likely to get taken down. I mean, YouTube hits you with enough strikes in a row, you're shitless to do anything. Needs to come out of nowhere, even if a video's been uploaded for a bit.
I want you to archive at least some of your videos, Jim.
I'll archive some of the classics.
Like the opening, the Pedo Rangers, all that.
Let me tell you something.
All your video edits.
I think most of my video edits is still on my laptop.
Stay in your lane.
They're all, so like, almost all of them are unlisted. The only way you can get to them is like if you have the link from Amino.
Or he's like scrolling through my account.
What'd you say?
Or he's like scroll through my Amino account.
Yeah.
Alright, back to back banner intros, let's do this shit.
Let's go!
You alright, Pete?
Yeah, I'm watching.
He's just watching Mr. Krabs versus Patrick. No undertones with this whatsoever. I don't know why he's named ChillBro. Like, whoever created them, is, I have no idea who Patrick is, but that's okay.
Yeah, there's some retard in this character.
Yeah, some fucking mouth breather.
You know what's funny is I'm so used to these like players is I don't even actually think of the actual characters anymore.
His face is so high up his head, and I feel that too.
I need like a constant edit of like SpongeBob the first three seasons, where like Patrick is just constantly wearing the "I hate kids" at the anime profile picture every single episode.
Like when I see Freddie Mercury, I just think Odrain.
Same.
When I see Freddie Mercury, I think Odrain.
Jim, also every time Patrick is on screen, like crop the screen up to his mouth. Call it the ChillBro, and call it the ChillBro cut.
The ChillBro cut. We gotta change some of the dialogue too for Patrick. We gotta have some K's in there.
Yeah, like SpongeBob goes like on this emotional rant, and he's like K.
Never forget ChillBro versus the Interviewer.
The ultimate feud.
No, that fucking Team Kaba match. My God, dude. That was the most boring match ever.
Turbo's got this sledgehammer, holy shit.
Might be a bit.
Imagine ChillBro moaning during sex and he just says K the entire time.
K. Okay. Yeah. The opposite of Hulk Hogan.
Oh yeah. Okay.
No, Pete. Hulk Hogan, apparently, when he was having sex, he was just like moaning the N-word. Yeah.
And it's so dirty sex, and he just kept fucking like the woman while he was on the phone.
We got out cancer games by Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, nobody thought insane. Of
that. Hulk Hogan has a new meta of moaning during sex.
Oh shit, hey, it's Ryder. Hulk Hogan was doing what my parents were doing during my conception.
Yelling the N-word?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Oh my god. Mr. Krabs!
Is Mr. Krabs, he's a KK.
Fucking up ChillBro here. My god. ChillBro, like, released, like, a long essay explaining to Mr. Krabs why he deserves a raise, and then Mr. Krabs just, like, laughed his ass off the out of the office.
He gives a Krusty Krab a whole one-star review and tells them why their food is, like, subpar compared to the chum bucket. They don't care.
It's like a show.
Is the only guy who has liked his review so far.
Yeah, ChillBro just becomes, like, this, like, pretentious Reddit user that has, like, these conspiracies about how the chum bucket's actually better than the Krusty Krab. Just because
I just want the motherfuckers to go, if there's a chum bucket, I'll be there. The Krusty Krab is going to have, like, one of those Chuck E. Cheese conspiracies.
Oh, Mr. Krabs is the claw! Two chill bros falls. Oh, my God. Not like there was much manhood to begin with, but oh, my God. Mr. Krabs. Oh, my God. Now he's burying his career. He's firing him from the company, and now ChillBro's forced to work for the chum bucket. Oh, my God.
You know what's fucked up? Mr. Krabs used his claws on ChillBro's crotch, and then he grabs a shovel like that one fucking episode where they bury the health inspector. Wait a minute. Wait.
Not that health inspector.
Yeah. The one fish health inspector.
I really need to make an edit of that episode.
Hey, you dropped that shovel. Pick that shit up.
Oh my god, Mr. Krabs. What is this, getting back to shovel after breaking the hockey stick? Imagine done, having bro. A boss, dude. That does this shit to you. Every time like you mess up an order or something, he just gets a shovel out, beats the shit out of you for like 10 minutes.
In front of the customers?
Yeah, in front of the customers, of course. Like, he's a dad.
Yeah, remember, this might be a bit random, but remember those like old like internet flash videos about like SpongeBob being like Chinese or like a stoner and that sort of stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, I miss those good days, those good old days with actual good content on the internet.
Dude, I wish the Grandma's Kisses naughty version was more well known.
yeah.
Damn.
You know, finally, ChillBro being able to get some ankle. Beetlejuice.
Beetlejuice.
Beetlejuice is in the call.
Beetlejuice has come in a call just to watch Mr. Krabs give ChillBro a life lesson. Oh, right against the mist on the Krusty Krab exterior. He slams the stop sign to the ground, not even like making contact with him, just out of rage.
I can't believe Ryder's gonna be Roman Reigns' WrestleMania opponent.
Man. For real.
Oh.
ChillBro somehow comes back. I'm gonna be pissed. Mr. Krabs has just been beating the shit out of him the entire match.
Ooh, that reverse.
Taking him to town. Ah, shit.
Not this guy.
Son of a bitch. Just found out this motherfucker asked for a raise.
No.
Just dive straight into Mr. Krabs. That's right. That's right. Mr. Krabs is still winning. He's getting back up. He's fine.
You know what?
I like money.
You know what's fucked up? Mr. Krabs canonically supposed to slay the king.
Who's the more corrupt?
Yeah, he's
why is that bad?
Like a human.
Who's the more corrupt boss, Mr. Krabs or Vince McMahon?
Mr. Krabs.
I don't think Mr. Krabs has made his employees do as fucked up stuff. I also don't think Vince McMahon would sell someone's soul for 62 cents, so I'm gonna have to say Mr. Krabs.
Jim,
what do you mean?
Jim, he literally tried to get SpongeBob to bury a guy. What are you talking about?
You know, Vince McMahon's in the same shit, dude. And also, Vince McMahon literally, challenged God.
Well, that's normal. There's nothing corrupt about that. You just want to prove you're superior.
Motherfucker said, God, you know I hate you, and I know you hate me.
At least he's being honest.
Oh, he was just being a Redditor in that moment.
Vince McMahon's like, I'm the incarnate of evil and shit like that. He literally had a kid have a custody match.
Okay, I am fucking tired of this plot armor bullshit for ChillBro. He's getting destroyed the entire match, and he's like got all his health back. He's got two finishers loaded up, which to be fair, Mr. Krabs hasn't used any of his.
Yeah, this is some JJ's bullshit.
You only see to stand up.
Wait, which Mr. Krabs is
get his ass.
Oh shit!
This is the Mr. Krabs from the manga.
This is the big baller brand, Mr. Krabs.
I was asking if it's like the Rock Lobster one.
Oh no.
No, this is just normal Mr. Krabs.
Rock Lobster?
This is the one who beats the fuck out of Oh no, that's it.
Oh wait, hold on! Mr. Krabs still hanging the slur. Oh no, he's going for another finisher. Shit. Fuck, come on, Mr. Krabs. Do another meaty.
Not another essay. Come on, dude.
Damn it. Oh.
Yeah, I don't think there's a spot for those ones.
He released a 5,000 word blog on Mr. Krabs, and that was it.
He released one, then he released another.
Too many 1-star reviews for the Krusty Krab. Too many essays has ruined the marketability. Now the Chum Bucket has more people come into their store because of one man.
No, they don't.
The 2-hour video essay. The Chum Bucket.
Maybe X convinced some homeless guy to come with him.
X would be the one guy who consistently goes to the Chum Bucket.
If there's a Chum Bucket, I'll be there.
Yeah, I could see a chat full of just Krusty Krabs supporting normal people, and then X is just the one guy. He's like, yeah, the Chum Bucket. He's probably the one guy in that episode that went to the Chum Bucket.
Yeah, that's probably X.
No, that's a match.
That's a match.